Hi everyone, so today we are going to discuss about integer parameters and date parameters. We've already discussed about what a parameter is and how it works, and then we saw some demonstration on how to use a string parameter. So when it comes to string parameter, basically a parameter, what tableau does is it will store whatever the value that give as a value input to the parameter, it will store separately, and then not to give it meaning, we actually use the parameter inside a calculation or a filter of any means possible. So what we are going to do now is we are going to create an integer parameter, and then we'll see how that integer parameter can be used inside a calculated field, and then how that can be used in a visualization, and also we'll see some places where the parameter value can be called in directly with respect to the visualization, and also we'll see how date parameter can be used effectively. Okay, so now let's connect to our data source. So we have connected to our usual data source, that is Superstores, and then now I'm going to bring in my orders tab. This is the data. Now let's start with the visualization. So now first let's create a parameter. Let's create, right, just right click on anywhere and then I'll go to create, and then from here I choose the parameters. So by default the data type here is float. I'll just rename this parameter as number parameter. That should be fine. Okay, and there's no trouble in having this as a float. That is what I'm going to demonstrate now. So let it be that. So like I said, when we had it as a string, the range was not apparent. So let's see. So when I have it as string, only all and list appears. So all means any alphabet or any string that we type in, it will take it as an input. But when we select list, what happens is we have to type in certain values, and only the parameter only will show these values, and we can only select from them. But when we select an integer or unfloat, what happens is the range also appears, which means the user can give input, but only any number as input, but only within these specified range. Okay, but I don't want that. I'll just use float. So if I select integer, I'll be able to only use normal whole numbers, but with float I can use any number, any decimal number also I can get in. Okay, so I'll just click all, and then I'll click OK. So my parameter is now created. I'll display this parameter by showing parameter control. So right now by default the value is 1. I can give in any value it will take. Okay. So if I put this in a visualization, it will not sit because we have to first create a calculation that gives it power. So I'll just right click on anywhere else, and then I'll create a calculation, create a calculated field, and then here what I'll do, I'll call the parameter. So number parameter that we have created, and the calculation mode, I'll click apply and then click OK, and then this if I bring in, so this if I bring in, let's see, let's put it discrete. Okay, so right now what is happening is we'll remove the aggregation. Okay, so right now the value is 14.3. So let me explain what had happened. So when I created this parameter has got only for the value 14.3 that we gave as an input. Okay, so what had happened is when I created a calculation, so basically when we create a calculation or a group, what happens is inside Tableau to the data a new column will be added. Okay, so this is the actual data that we have connected, and then we can view the data from clicking this small icon here. Okay, so this actually show all the data that we are currently using, and as you can see the calculation one is also created. So what happens is with this calculation it will create a separate column, and it will populate this column will be populated with whatever the value that we give in the parameter, because in the calculation we have called in the parameter. If at all I create a calculation where having a case statement if state is equal to Kentucky, then one else two. If I create a calculation like that, what happens is a calculation column will be created. The all these rows that are Kentucky will be populated as one, and then else will be populated as two. Okay, and just using a random example to explain what a calculated field is. Okay, so now when I call this parameter inside my calculated, it got populated for each and every row. And now you, when I initially brought in the calculation, it was showing me some big number that is actually the sum of this 14.3 across all the records. Okay, so that is what it was showing. Okay, so now let's do something more innovative. So now that I show that here to this data, there can be a value which is dynamic. Whatever the input that I give here will be reflected here. So instead of 14.3, let's change now this to 2. Okay, if I give a 2, the calculation will be updated to 2. If I view my data now, you can see that it will be, if this field will be the value would have been updated as 2 everywhere. Okay, if I want this to be conditional, if I want this value to be populated in targeted rows, I should be writing logical and functional calculations inside my functions inside my calculation. So we'll discuss about what are all the various calculations and functions in the future videos. Okay, right now we're just gonna leave it at this. Okay, so now that I have a dynamic value here, I can control the visualization the way I want by manipulating the calculation. So suppose I'll just edit this. I can just multiply. Suppose if I want to double, if I want the visualization where I double the profit, I just have to multiply it by profit. Okay, so this will, I'll just apply and then click OK. So now here what I can do is make the aggregate meshes enabled, and then now if I display the segments, I'll change these to discrete continuous itself. I'll change the marks to text. Okay, and then I'll display the profit. You can see the profit, the calculation is actually the result of twice the profit. If I change here, it will also get changed. So you understand now the implication of using an integer parameter. Okay, so this is about integer parameter. Now let's see a date parameter. We'll take in a practical scenario to better understand a date calculation. Okay, so now what I want is, so let's say this is our requirement. So we want to display region, region wise sales. We'll display the sales. Okay, so right now this sales is actually the aggregated sales of all the months and years that are present inside the data. Okay, so what are all the years present inside the data? Let's take the order date into consideration. Right now there are four different years: 2015, 16, 17 and 18. So we have four different years of data, and then this is actually the aggregation of all the 4 years. If I want to filter out to one particular year, I can just put my order date into my filter pane and then choose it as years and then click next. For right now I'll choose it as all, apply and then click OK, and from here I can show the filter. Okay, from here I can manipulate it the way I want. Okay, so this can be done. Okay, or if I want if I want to filter the data month wise, I can also do that here. Okay, I can edit the filter, we'll remove and then we'll insert it again. Okay, I would remove, insert the orders again, and then I'll put month and year together. okay, first of all now I'll select all, apply, and then okay, and then from here I'll show the filter. So I can select any specific month I want. Okay, I'll just deselect everything and then I'll select November, okay, and then December. But what happens here is, no matter how many months I select, all of them will be aggregated in a single point. Okay, so suppose if I want to show the sales here dynamically, like if I select here November, and then automatically the data for the month prior to the month that I've selected should appear here. In order to provide that sort of a scenario, we can go for a parameter. Okay, so now this is what I'm going to do. So the requirement is, whenever I select a month and a year, that month and year should come here as current month sales. Okay, and then there should be a separate column where it shows the previous month sales side by side. Okay, so this is what we are going to do. So now let's go ahead and then create a date parameter. Okay, so I'll just right click on anywhere I want. So since we are going to create a date parameter, I'll just use date and then create parameter. So by default a date parameter would have been created. Okay, and then from the list whatever the values that are present in the order date only will be used to create this parameter. Okay, let's click OK and let's remove this filter. Let's now hide this card, we don't want this card. Okay, I'll remove this as well, remove the filter. So now I'll show this parameter control, and so right now this is the parameter, but right now you can see that it is showing the date, month and year. I do not want the date, exact date, I just want the month and year. To do that, I'll have to edit the filter display format. So I just click on edit, and then here it is set to automatic. So instead of automatic, I'll just choose one where which has the month and the year. Okay, so this shows us the month and year, so I'll just choose this one. Okay, if at all I want a custom one, I can go and type the one I want. Okay, so this seems to be fine, I'll just click OK, and so you can see it is showing just the month and year. Like I always said, in a parameter you can only select one value at a time, you cannot select multiple values, it will not allow. Okay, so right now I'm selecting the value, but it is not reflecting here. Okay, it is not reflecting here at all. Okay, so what to do now? I have to input this parameter to a calculation and then put that calculation inside my filter, and in order for me to filter this data based on my selection. So basically, when you want to filter out the data based on your parameter selection, you have to create a calculation, logical calculation, and then put that calculation inside a filter. Okay, or in this case I wanted it to be displayed as a separate column, so I'm just going to create a calculation which shows the sales only for the dates that are selected here. Okay, so to do that, what we need is, so here let's I'll show you a shortcut in order for us to get the right date format. Let's create another sheet here. If I double click on date, the dates will be displayed. So here what you have to do is click the down arrow and then select your month. Okay, and then select discrete. Okay, and then if you double click here, what happens is it will give you the actual calculation for getting the month and year from any present date column that is inside the data. Okay, so we'll go here, we'll go to our data, we'll create a calculation, create a calculated field, and then we'll select all, we'll remove this, and then we'll paste it here. Okay, so date, so this is not the calculation I was looking for. Okay, so select this way. Choose custom. We'll choose month versus year, date part, and then click OK. Now it will give me the this is the calculation I was looking for. Okay, I apologize for the confusion caused. So I'll create a calculation now. Create a calculated field. I'll remove everything from here. So this is basically my order date, which has my year and the month alone. Okay, so I'll match this with the parameter. Okay, so here what I'll do, I'll bring this down in order for us to be visible. I'll display this. And then instead of the order date here, I'll call in the parameter. Order date parameter. Okay. Parameter we're calling. So this gives us the month and year of the parameter, and the above one gives us the month and year of the parameter. Here I have used a conditional operator which compares my both the dates. Okay, so we'll discuss about the various types of calculation later on, but right now you just have to understand that this will give you a Boolean expression. This is actually a Boolean expression which gives you either true or false. So this is a conditional operator which compares whatever the expression that is present in the left side to the expression present in the right side. So on the left side we have the month and year of the order date, and the right side we have the month and year of the parameter. Okay, I'll just click apply, and then I'll rename this as date sales. So let it be date sales. I'll click apply, and then I'll click OK. So you can see date sales would have been created as a conditional parameter. Okay, so now if I put it in the filter section, it will ask me for null, false and true. Null means that there are some data which doesn't come under these two conditions. Okay, we'll not worry about that now. If I select true and then click apply and then click OK, this filter will be applied here. So right now, whatever the month I'm selecting, that month sales alone is now showing here. Okay, so that month sales is now alone showing here. So let's now create a calculation which actually displays the sales year separately. Instead of applying as a filter, we'll create a calculation that gives the actual value. Okay, so we'll make a copy of this. Okay, I'll edit this. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create a logical if expression. So if this condition is true, this order date, the month and year of the order date is equal to the month and year of the parameter date, then give me sum of sales. Give me sum of sales. Okay, else 0. End. So this is going to be my calculation. So let's see what the error is. Okay. Okay. We didn't need the sum now. Okay. So what happens? So this is a simple calculation. So only if the dates match, it should give me the sales, or else it should give me 0. So this will bring me the current month sales or chosen month. Okay, or selected month. Will you selected month? Okay, apply. And then OK. Okay, so I don't want this as a, I want it as a measure. So what I will do, I'll display this value. So the first one will give me the actual sales. Okay, this is actually showing me the entire sales, and the second one is showing me sales of the selected month alone. Okay, so what are the month I am selecting, For that alone, it is showing me the sales. Now I'll create a calculation for me to display the previous month sales also. So to do that, I just have to go, I'll duplicate the calculation, and then I'll edit this to achieve it. So here I'll rename it as previous month sales. And then, so what we are trying to achieve is whatever the date that we are selecting should be the date that we are selecting, Tableau should get it as 1 month prior to that date. So in order to achieve that, I'm just going to put here -1. Okay, so this should give me the previous month. So what we are doing, whatever the month that a month and year that we are selecting, it will be taken here, and here we are subtracting 1 month from that. Suppose if I'm selecting December of 2014, when it comes here to the calculation, it will be December of 2014, and it will apply this -1. It will be converted to as November 2014, and that November 2014 will be compared with all the order dates that are present inside Tableau, and then it will fetch me only the November 2014 value. I'll click apply, and then this I'll now put this calculation also. So you can see this is showing. So in order to prove this, we'll create a separate sheet where it shows a region and sales. So let's display region, and then let's display sales, and then I'll put the order date into my filters and choose, and then next, and then I'll choose all initially, apply, and then click OK. So here I'll show the filter. Okay, so instead of selecting everything, what I'll do, I'll select now, let's say December of 2015. So this is the sales of December of 2015. For central it is 10,636. Okay, now let's go to worksheet, and then now let's select December of 2015. This is December of 2015. You can see the selected month sales is 10,636, and the previous month sales is 7,497. So this should be the sales of the November month. So we'll verify that also. If I select November, it should be 14058, and here it is showing me 14058. So this I'll conclude the date parameter and integer parameter. So this is how we can use the date inside a parameter. And even if the display format is controlled by us, we have to, when we are inserting it into a calculation, we have to make sure that we type in the correct format calculation in order to get out the results that is desired. Thank you. Hi everyone. So along with this integer and date parameter, there's another way to use the in which we can use the integer parameters. Okay, so this is the number parameter that we have already created. Let me display this value, and let me edit this parameter first. Okay, so instead of float, I'll put it to an integer, and then I'll click OK. Okay, so what happens is, so the other way we can use this parameter is inside a visualization. Okay, so let's now build a basic chart that gives me the region and sales. Let's display it as a bar chart. Okay, and then let's swap it so that it's a standing bar chart. Okay, so here you can see there's a scale. So when it comes to Tableau's visualizations, that when you're plotting a chart, you're basically like crafting a value towards in a graph. Okay, so that is what it is basically doing. So by default you'll be having a scale along with you. This scale, like, there's multiple options you can do with this scale. So you just have to right click here, and then it will show you what are all the options you can do with your scale. So the first thing is, you can edit your axis. Inside the axis, sorry, So inside your edit axis option, you can see there are like multiple options for you to get the scale as reversed or logarithmic, or you can change the title of the sales, title of the scale the way you want. You can choose include to zero, use your uniform axis. All these various options you can change, or you can change the tick appear, the way the tick marks are appearing. So all this you can change. Okay, along with the editing the axis, there's an selected tick marks or format or show header. If I click on show, if I remove the show header, this entire scale will be hidden. Okay, so apart from all these normal things, you can have this thing called as the reference line to a chart. Okay, so what reference line is basically when you are having large amount of data and then you want to show a reference line, compare the data that you have, you can always go for a reference line. Okay, so what the reference line does is, so you're basically plotting a line for your reference. Okay, so for now what I'll do, I'll choose your parameter. Okay, so when I choose here, so before parameter, I'll just show you sales, and then I'll use the average of sales. So what I'm doing here, I'm taking the average of the sales and then using that to show my reference line. Okay, so let's see. So here there's a reference line created, and this value is actually the average of the entire sales. So you can like use this to come to get to know that what are all the segments or region, in this case a region, what are all the regions that have sales more than the average sale. Okay, so we can categorize them as good performing regions. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll edit the reference line now. Okay, so instead of getting an average line, suppose you're displaying, instead of sales, let's display a profit. Okay, so let's display a profit. This is the profit according to various region, and then like, yeah, you want to like instead of region, you have something like country or city, let's say state. Instead of a region, you have like, there are like multiple states, and then like in the first glimpse itself, you would want to know what are all the states that have performed based on the value that you are given. So in that sort of a scenario, you can just go here, edit the reference line, and instead of giving it, so this is like hard coding, you are just using sales, one hard coded value. So we can dynamically give in any value through a parameter. So here there what are the parameter that we have created, numeric parameter that we have created, it will be displayed. Along with this, you can create a parameter from here also. If you just click on this create a new parameter, you will be a new parameter creation dialog box will be created, and then like from there you can access this. Okay, I'll just click this, I'll click OK, and then what I'll do is I'll change this to 40k. So my parameter is now 40k. What I'll do, I can even add I'll edit this reference line to color code. I can like fill all the values that are above with let's say green. I'll use this one very dark. I'll use a lighter version. I'll use this one, and then what are all the values that are performed below my expectation, I'll give this color. I'm sorry, I've chosen black. Okay, so I can perform like these two states have performed according to my expectation. So I'll change this to 23. Okay, something is picking up. Okay, so this is the use of, this is another way of using a parameter. Thanks for watching. Hi everyone. So now that we have discussed about parameters, let's discuss about groups, sets and calculated fields. So like we saw in parameters, whenever we create a parameter and whatever the value that parameter holds, it will be placed in an it will be placed in a separate area within Tableau. So Tableau will have allocated a separate memory space for the parameters that we create. So whatever the value that we give as input to the parameter, that value will be stored inside that value will be stored inside that parameter. If at all that parameter is called inside a calculation, a separate column will be created as part of the data, and then within that data, if we have called in the parameter, a separate column would have been created with the values that that is given as input to the parameter. Okay, so okay, we would remove the calculator, so that's okay. When creating a calculated field, what basically happens is a new column gets created. So there are other options when we try to create something. So when I go to right click on any column, and then when I go to create, when I right click on a dimension, and when I go to create, what happens is it gives me calculated. Let's select this one, a pure dimension. Okay, it gives me calculated fields, groups, sets, and parameters. Okay, when I click on a measure or any integer value, it gives me a different set of options. Okay, the calculated fields and groups and parameters will be the same, but you see here it is not showing sets, instead it's showing us bins. Okay, so whenever we create sets with the parameter with strings, we call them as sets, and then when it is created using a measure or a value, it is called as bins. Okay, so both of them vary in lots of ways, but we'll see one by one. Okay, so first let's discuss about groups. Okay, so what basically grouping is? Okay, so inside Tableau, suppose if we have data in a particular column, let's say this category and subcategory. Okay, so here what it is showing is, it is showing me furniture and subcategories. Okay, so this all this this bookcases, chairs, furnishing and tables, all these four values comes under a group called as the furniture. This is the actual data that is present inside our data source. I'm just using it to explain groups. Okay, so this is called as a furniture. And then appliances, art, and all this stuff is grouped under office supplies, and all these remaining are grouped under technology. So this is a grouping that is by default present inside our data source. Suppose if I want to regroup this in a different name, okay, suppose like if I want to add chairs, say bookcases and arts, if I want to add like bookcases, arts, and apply and binders to a separate group. Okay, so what I can do is I can create a group here. So how to do that? So what I'll do is, from the right category subcategory, I'll just right click over this and I will go to create and then create group. So from till now, whatever we did is, we right click any, in order to create a parameter, we right clicked on anywhere and then we created a parameter. If we were to create a parameter right clicking on any particular column, those the value from those column will be taken as input to that parameter list. Okay, not the input to the parameter, it will be taken as input to the list that it will show. Okay, similarly, if I go to if I want to create a group using subcategory, I have to right click on subcategory and then go to create and then create group. Okay, so right now the group is not created, it is just show, a new window is now open. This window will help me creating the group. So here you can see there's an option called as groups and then add to. So what it will show you, what basically it will show us, it will show us all the existing groups that are present inside, not the data set, whatever the groups that we have created, it will display here, and then we can light all these values to that particular group. So right now what it is doing is, it is displaying me all the values present inside subcategory in this particular data. Okay, this particular data. So it is showing me everything. Let's say I want to add bind arts, bind let's say arts, binders, and then bookcases. I am actually clicking on control and then clicking multiple values. Okay, and then let's say envelopes. All these four values, I want them in a separate group. So I have selected all this and then I am going to do a click on this group. a group is now created. I'll rename this group to something that I want. I'll rename this as group 1, okay, for my own convenience. I'm creating a group called as group 1. So now that we have created group 1, you see this is now enabled. So this will now show me group 1. So if at all, if I click on any other values, and then if I click on this group 1, it will be added. So this is one way of adding, or I can just drag this value and then place it here, it will be added. There's no hierarchy created when we are adding to a particular group. Now it doesn't take into consideration of consideration the order in which the values are being placed inside that particular group. If I ungroup this, whatever the values that I will select it, it will just ungroup it. Okay. Or and then what the other option that is present inside this is include others. So what this will do is, now we have created a group 1 and all the other values will be showing as separate values. Now let's show that. Okay, click apply. I'll just click OK. I'll create a new sheet, and then in this new sheet I will create this display this group. Okay, so you can see that with along with all the other values, group 1 is also present. And then if I display the subcategories along with them, you can see all these values are grouped under group 1. Okay, similarly how here the values are grouped under this category, that is actually the data that is coming in inside this from the source, but here we have created a new set of group. Suppose we want to create other groups, I can also do that, but instead of doing that, let me edit this. Okay, I'll edit this group, and then I'll show include get this include others. So what this will do is, this will basically group all the other remaining values and then put them inside my inside a custom group called as the create others. Okay, or I can rename this to whatever I want. Okay, I'll just name it as others, and then I'll click apply, and then click OK. So right now you can see it is just showing me group 1 and others. So I'll remove the subcategory, and then I'll display the sales. So right now we can like compare the group 1 sales to the other sales, or else let's create edit this group even further. Edit this group, and then I'll deselect everything. Okay, I'll ungroup all this. I'll click apply. I'll click OK. So when I add subcategory here, you can see the group 1 has got only arts, and everything else is grouped separately. So this will be an easy way for me if I want to compare any one particular value to the other value. So this is just one application of groups. And when I created this group, you can see here, observe here that there is a separate column that is being created here. I can rename this to whatever I want. We will see inside the data source what has happened. Okay. So inside our data source, you can see that along with the subcategory, along with the subcategory that is present, there is also a new column generated with the group that we created. Okay, excuse me. So a separate column is added as a group. So this is how group functions. You should understand that whenever we are creating a parameter, it does not add itself to the data source like group does. It will be a separate value stored in a separate place. Okay, and then when we are creating a calculation using that parameter, then only that parameter reflects as a column inside our data source. But the group, at the instant it has been created, it will be integrated as a separate column to our data source. Okay, so this is like a grouping function that is present inside Tableau. So instead of going to instead of creating this group, we can also like use a calculation in order to create a group. So let's create a calculation with this subcategory. I'll just use create calculated field. Okay, and then here I'll just type in if subcategory is equal to art, then I'll type in as group 1, else others. Just other. End. Okay. This is a calculation group. I'll click apply and then I'll click OK. So now what happens is, if I bring this into my calculation, you can see it will remain the same. Okay, let's bring in the subcategory for reference. You can see this also shows me the, remove this group created using the group option. Now the calculated group is 11%. Here also it will show me the same exact value. Okay, so this is regarding grouping inside Tableau. And this grouping, like instead of like creating a group from a calculation or other options, we can also like create a group by other means as well. Okay, so now let's plot profit and sales, and then sales in detail. So like, so this is like a distributed chart. Now here I can like from the chart itself I can like select multiple values, and then if I right click over here, you can see there is an option called as group here. I can group them from here itself. Okay, so it will automatically group them as one. Whatever the values I have selected, it will group them as one part, and the others will create a group as others. Okay, so it has now color coded it. Okay, so this can also, this is also a method for us to create groups. Okay, thank you. Next we'll discuss about sets. So, and along with multiple ways of creating groups, and then one small thing I like to add up to these groups, that is, we discussed about hierarchies, right? So, we've already discussed about how to create a hierarchy. Suppose if you want to create a hierarchy with category and subcategory, I just go here and then create a hierarchy. Let's say in subcategory. And then to this hierarchy, I just add these. And so here there's a hierarchy created for category and subcategory. Okay, so instead of using category as subcategories, the values, the columns that are already present inside my from my data source, I can use these calculated fields or my groups that are created as part of my hierarchy as well. So I'll create a hierarchy with this group that we have created. I'll click OK. So you can see the hierarchy is created, and to this I will duplicate this, and then I will add this to my new hierarchy. Okay, so now if I go and create a separate sheet, if I put this inside my hierarchy, you can see it will also work. Okay, so this is regarding groups. Thank you.